and exalted. The carriers in the spirit of all. Amazing and wonderful. The text says they feared exceedingly. And I noticed they were more afraid of the power of the man that sees the storms than the storms have. Therefore, causing them to marvel and say to one another, what manner of man? Let us, if you will, take a brief pause and pull back the curtain of history and examine great men. You find that many have shaped the affairs and the conditions of this world. Alexander the Great modernized the world 300 years before the time of Jesus. Alexander marched his armies over vast expanses of territory, capturing foreign lands. He inoculated them with Greek culture and gave birth to advanced schools of thought, learning, and philosophy. Alexander was so great, great follow his name. History records one by the name of Caesar, name or official title of the Roman Emperor. We heard of Julius Caesar, Augustus Caesar, both lived at the time of Jesus. Tiberius Caesar, Claudius Nero, who killed Peter and Paul, and the Bible goes with information, who sentenced John on an island. Have us to see these great men, but before modern times, if we were to take a panoramic view of history's great men, reveals leaders in every aspect of life. Great men like Winston Churchill, great statesman, led Britain during World War II. Franklin D. Roosevelt, John F. Kennedy, Gandhi, and Einstein, all are just a few. Tomorrow, we're going to celebrate Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., preacher, civil rights leader, all great men. In the coming months, we're going to talk about Frederick Douglass, Booker T. Washington, W.E.B. Du Bois, Langston Hughes, all great men that divide the course of history coming from various backgrounds of nationality. We sing their praises, we speak of their accomplishments, we hold them in esteem, their truths and their teachings. We embrace the schools they graduated from. We make shrines and places where their footsteps are tried. We celebrate their impact on society. And still feel their efforts on our lives as we do. But I need to share with you the biography of a man that has done more to shape the course of human history than any other who came before or after. I said my assignment this morning. I came here with the purpose of the Holy Spirit sent me in a hurry. I know it's a little late this morning, but I was still making notes because number one, the Spirit wants me to number one introduce him to you if you don't know. Secondly, if you do know him, I want to encourage you to follow him. And thirdly, if you know him, I don't want you to just go out with him, but I want you to